Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see a problem in which we are going to design the dimensions for a given column. Here is the question. I'll write whatever is given here in the form of a data. Now it is given that a hollow circular steel column 8 meter long, so I'll write the type. It is hollow circular column which is 8 meter long, so the length of the column is 8 meter, that is 8000 mm. Next, supports an axial load of 200 kilonewtons, so I'll write it as load P 200 kilonewton, so 200 into 10 raised to 3 newton. Next, both the ends of the column are fixed, so I'll write it here, both ends of column are fixed. Then the internal diameter of the column is 0.8 times the external diameter, so I'll denote internal diameter as small d. It is 0.8 times of capital D given, which is the external diameter. Using Euler's formula, determine the external diameter and thickness of metal for this column. So I have to use Euler's formula and find external diameter and the thickness of metal to be used for this column. Take factor of safety as 4, FOS as 4, and capital E, that is Young's modulus, is 2 into 10 raised to 5 megapascal. So it is 2 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square. Now, since they have given factor of safety and we have to use Euler's formula, so we would require Euler's load. It means the problem, in the problem, the load which they have given, this axial load of 200 kilonewton, it is nothing but the safe load, because we will use this safe load and FOS to get Euler's load. So now with the data with us, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now in the solution part, first I'll draw the cross section. So this is the column cross section. Here I have denoted external diameter as capital D, internal diameter as small d, and this is the metal thickness. So here is the thickness of metal. So in this problem we have to find out how much is this capital D, that is the external diameter and the metal thickness here. Now as they have given axial load and factor of safety, and in the problem they have given us to use the Euler's formula, so first I'll say that since safe load is given by P suffix safe, that is equal to Euler's load upon the factor of safety. So therefore P safe becomes P suffix E upon FOS. So finally we want Euler's load, that will be P safe into FOS. Here P safe, the safe load in the problem given as 200 into 10 raised to 3 newton. Factor of safety it has 4. So Euler's load comes out to be 800 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Now in the problem, we would be using this load formula. Next, I'll write the formula of Euler's load, that since Euler's crippling load is given by P suffix E, it is equal to pi square E I minimum upon effective length square . So I'll keep this as equation number 1. Now we have Euler's load, pi is a constant, capital E is given in the problem, 2 into 10 raised to 5, only unknown is I minimum, so I'll go and find this, that therefore minimum moment of inertia for hollow circular section, I minimum is equal to Ixx and it is equal to Iyy, because for a circular section or hollow circular section, moment of inertia about x and y, they are same. So therefore I minimum will be pi by 64 capital D raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4. Now in the problem they have given this relation of small d, that is small d is 0.8 times of capital D. I'll put the value here. So therefore I minimum will be equal to pi by 64 capital D raised to 4 minus 0.8 capital D raised to 4. So hence I minimum will be equal to, now here if we see we have pi by 64, we can take D raised to 4 common, so in the bracket we have 1 raised to 4 minus 0.8 raised to 4. So therefore I minimum, here I am going to calculate this entire value, 1 raised to 4 minus 0.8 raised to 4 multiplied by pi by 64, my answer will be 0.0289 capital D raised to 4, that is I am getting the minimum moment of inertia in the form of capital D. Now I'll say that therefore put all values in equation number 1. So in equation 1 we have first of all Euler's load that we have found out, it was 800 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to pi square capital E value, that is 2 into 10 raised to 5 given. Now minimum moment of inertia we have found out, 0.0289 D raised to 4 divided by effective length. Now if we see in the question, it was given that both the ends of the column are fixed, so if we have both the ends of the column as fixed, then this much is the length of the column, and when the load is acting at that time, the column will bend in this way, that is it will start bending away from the fixed end and it will stop bending just before the free end. So this much is the length which bends or which actually takes part in the bending, that is called as effective length, and for such a condition effective length is taken as L by 2, that is half of the length. Now the length was given as 8000, so divided by 2, effective length is 4000 mm. So I'll put this value of 4000 mm in the denominator, 4000 it is square. So here I have put all the values, in equation number 1, effective length square. Now when I calculate this, I'll get d raised to 4 on one side, shift all the terms on the other side. So my d raised to 4 answer comes out to be 224.38 into 10 raised to 6. Now I want the answer of d. So taking the square root twice, therefore I'll get the answer of capital D. So now after I'm calculating the square root twice, that is, it was d raised to 4. So taking square root twice, I'll get the answer of D, and that comes out to be 122.39. Since it is diameter, I'll round off the value and make it as 123 mm. So here I've got the external diameter. So this is the first answer. Now in the question, they have given that small d is 0.8 times of capital D. So I'll say that therefore small d is 0.8 capital D. So it is 0.8 into 123. So here I get small d value as 98.4 mm. Now after getting this, we want metal thickness. So this metal thickness T can be calculated as, it will be capital D minus small d, which will give us 2t. So here this would be 2t is equal to capital D minus small d. Thickness will be on both the sides, so thickness becomes capital D minus small d by 2. This is the formula. So therefore I'll write down thickness of metal, small t is equal to capital D minus small d divided by 2. So therefore this will be 123 minus 98.4 divided by 2. That comes out to be 12.3 mm. This is the second answer. And once we have calculated the external diameter and the thickness of metal, we can say that both the unknowns are known. And with this, we complete the question.